Hello everyone. In this video, we'll learn about inheritance in Java. Right. First of all, what is inheritance? Inheritance is an object-oriented feature which allow a class to inherit behavior and data from the other class. Okay. You can use inheritance in Java by extending classes and implement interfaces. Java provide two keywords, that is extends and implements, to achieve inheritance. Right? A class which is derived from another class is known as is subclass, and interface which is derived from another interface is called as subinterface. A class which implements an interface is known as implementation. Right? There are term used in inheritance. First is class. A class is a group of objects which have common properties. It is a template or blueprint from which objects are created. Then there is subclass or child class. Subclass is a class which inherits the other class. It is also called a derived class, extended class, or child class. Superclass or parent class, right? Superclass is the class from where a subclass inherits the features. It is also called a base class or a parent class. Right? Then reusability. As the name specifies, reusability is a mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the field and method of the existing class when you create a new class. You can use the same field and methods already defined in the previous class. Right? You need not to define or declare the same methods again and again. You can use the methods and variables of superclass if you are using the inheritance. Right? Now the types of inheritance. First is single. In single inheritance, a single class inherits a single class. That means there is only one base class and only one child class. Right? Multi-level inheritance. Suppose class B inherits class A and class C inherits class B. Then there are levels. Okay? Then it is called multi-level. Then comes hierarchical. Hierarchical means two class inherit the same class. That means there is a base class, but there are more than one child class, right? Then comes multiple. Multiple means there is only one child class, but there are more than one base class. Then comes hybrid. Hybrid means there is a base class, there is only one base class, and there are more than one child class, and these child class also the base class for another the class, that is class T. Right? Now, syntax of Java inheritance. In Java, if we are using inheritance in Java, then we will use the keyword extends, right? The class, subclass name, then keyword extends, and then superclass or base class name, right? Then comes in class body, comes method and fields. Right now, see, we are taking example of single inheritance. When a class inherits another class, it is known as a single inheritance. Right? For example, we are taking this example. Now see what the output will come. Right, there is a class that is animal, then there is a method called eat in that animal class, right? The definition of that method is simply type, simply that method is printing simply eating statement, right? Then there is another class that is dog, which inherit animal class, right? So we will type class name, that is dog, extends. We are using extend keywords, right? देन द बेस क्लास इज द पेरेंट क्लास दैट इज एनिमल. देन द स्टेटमेंट विल कम क्लास दैट इज क्लास नेम इज डॉग, क्लास डॉग एक्सटेंड्स एनिमल क्लास. राइट, इन डॉग क्लास वी आर यूजिंग वन मेथड दैट इज बार्क. द बार्क मेथड सिंपली प्रिंट द स्टेटमेंट बार्किंग. राइट, देन वी आर क्रिएटिंग एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डॉग क्लास दैट इज डी. सो वी विल सिंपली टाइप डॉग डी इक्वल्स टू न्यू डॉग ब्रैकेट. वी आर नॉट पासिंग एनी पैरामीटर्स, सो इट विल कॉल डिफॉल्ट कंस्ट्रक्टर. राइट, देन वी फर्स्ट कॉल द मेथड ऑफ डॉग क्लास दैट इज बार्क. देन वी विल सिंपली टाइप डी डॉट बार्क. राइट, नाउ द डॉग क्लास ऑल्सो एक्सटेंडिंग या इम्प्लीमेंटिंग या इनहेरिट्स द एनिमल क्लास. वी कैन यूज द वेरिएबल एंड मेथड ऑफ एनिमल क्लास ऑल्सो. ओके, देन दे यू कैन सी देर इज वन मेथड इन एनिमल क्लास दैट इज ई. सो वी कैन एक्सेस दिस मेथड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ डॉग क्लास. राइट, तो वी सिंपली टाइप द ऑब्जेक्ट नेम दैट इज डी. राइट, डॉट मेथड नेम ऑफ दैट एनिमल क्लास दैट इज ई. वो सिंपली टाइप वी विल सिंपली टाइप डी डॉट ई. इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली कॉल द मेथड ऑफ एनिमल क्लास. ओके, नाउ एग्जीक्यूट दिस प्रोग्राम. व्हाट विल हैपन, जस्ट what it is printing. First it is printing the output of the method of dog class, then it is printing the output of method of animal class, barking and eating. Right, now comes multi-level inheritance. Multi-level inheritance means being there is a chain of inheritance, it is known as multi-level inheritance. Right, suppose class B inherit class A and class C inherit class B. Right, then it is called multi-level inheritance. Okay, now take this example of multi-level inheritance. What will happen? There is a class animal, right? Then there is a method in animal class that is eat. Okay, eat method simply printing eating statement, right? Then there is a dog class which inherits the animal class. Right, then there is a state there is a method in dog class that is bark. Bark method is simply printing statement barking. Right, then there is another class that is baby dog which extends the dog class. Right, you can assume animal as A class, dog as B class, and baby dog as C class. Now B is inheriting A class and baby dog as C. If you assume it as C class, then C class is inheriting the dog class, that is class B. So you can see there a chain of inheritance is there. So it is called multi-level inheritance. In baby dog class, there is a method that is weep. Weep is simply printing statement that is weeping. Right? Okay. Then we are just creating an object of that baby dog class, right? That is D, object D, right? Then we will simply call methods or access method of these three class from this object only. The first is method of baby dog class that is V. We will simply type D dot V. Then we will use method of dog class because baby dog is inheriting dog class. It can also access the method of that dog class that is bark method. So simply we will type D dot bark. Okay. Now B is also inheriting the class animal. So we can also access method of that animal class from this object only. So we'll simply type d dot a, right? So all these methods of these three class can be accessed from one object only, right? Now execute this program. What will happen? It will simply first it is printing weeping because the output of weep method is weeping. Then it will print barking because output of bark method is barking. Then it is printing eating because the output of that eat method of animal class is eating. So it will simply type, simply will give output eating. Right? I hope you will understand the inheritance concept from this video. Now.